So today I wanted to share this short video with you on how I design a sublimation template. This template is of a chapstick or lip balm substrate, and I got it from halebound.com. That's halebound.com. And I buy some of my blanks from her, and she also provides the template, so makes it easier than having to, you know, do your own. And it makes it easier to design, and then it makes it better, make sure you have your bleed lines, and it's just very, very helpful. So now I'm going to be customizing this digital paper a little bit. I got this digital paper on Etsy, and there's a lot of different designers that sell digital paper and clip art and everything so that you could use it on your projects. Just double check the terms if you're going to use it for business though, because they do have limited licenses on there where if it's for business, some allow it, some don't. But if it's for personal use, it's usually not a problem because that's why they actually sell it on there. And so Valentine's Day is coming, so I kind of want to add the word "be mine" here. And the way you do that is by making sure that the text tool is selected. And then you can hover over to, or go over to the bone and click on there. And you'll see that a layer has been added to your layers palette. And you can just add the words that you'd like. And in order to confirm it and for it to be accepted, you'll see like a check mark up here, and you kind of have to check it or also push enter. And so I like this font, but let's just say that you didn't. You could also come over here, and there's a gazillion different fonts that you can pick from, and there's even more you can add if you really want to, but I like this font that I picked. If it's selected and you see this little arrow, that means that you can move it around wherever you like. Even if you don't like it on the bone, maybe you like it right here. And then once again, you'll see the check mark and you have to confirm it or push enter. And I do want to see if I could change the color though. I kind of like this red color that's darker red here. And so you do that by clicking on it like this and then coming over to this color picker. And once you hover over the paper, you get this little dropper, and you can pick any color that you want. It's very helpful. So I'm going to pick this red and push OK. And for some reason, it didn't work. So let's try that again. Sometimes I kind of miss a step. So I'm going to come back over to the color picker, pick the color, and there we go. Now it's changed colors, and then you just got to accept it. So there we go. Now, I don't particularly like this angle that it's at. I kind of want it to go at the same angle that the bone is at. So in order to do that, you actually have to come up here to the Move tool. Up here, it's usually on the top left. And then you're gonna look for this little handle thing. It's like two little arrows with a, like half a circle. And then it'll help you angle it. And you can make it bigger or smaller. Or, you know, you can change the angle once again. And then once you're done again, you have to push enter it to take, and then you'll see that if you click off of it, it, you know, change the angle. So it's kind of still not in the area that I want it to be, so I'm going to move it around a little bit. Another trick is to kind of push the control button, which is the CTRL button, and kind of the arrow, the up arrow, and you can move it around and kind of position it where you want that way. Sometimes that's easier. So now that I kind of got it where I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can add like a little outline or stroke, I guess, just to see how it looks and just to show you guys that you can also just add like a border. It just depends. Photoshop calls it, it's like a style effect or a stroke. And so the way you do that is you have to make sure that your that layer is selected, and you go down here to the FX down at the bottom, and you're gonna see the word stroke. And so then that's gonna pop up this box, and you're gonna see that the black is selected. You can really pick any color that you want, but I actually did want black. And here you're going to see that you can make this like as the outline or the stroke as wide as possible. And then we have the opacity where you can make it lighter, where it almost changes the color like to gray. But I just like to keep this very low. I'm just gonna keep it there at number 2, and I'm just gonna keep the opacity all the way up. And so you can kind of play with these other things, but like if you want it on the inside or on the center, but I like it on the outside the best for this project. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do that. And you're gonna see that all the effects here were added to this layer. So now what I wanna do is add the words to all these other little bones that are around it. And you do that by copying this layer and then moving it around. There's just actually several ways of doing things, but I think this is the simplest way for a beginner. And since this video is mainly for beginners, this is the way I first learned how to do it. So you come to the layer and then you click it, and you can actually drop it there and see you made a copy. So they're stacked on each other, and you can make another copy and another one and another one. You can also go and just do control, you know, the C button and copy it that way with a shortcut. But for right now, we're just gonna do it this way. You drop it down to this little one down here at the bottom. I'm not sure actually what that's called. I guess it's to copy. But, and once you have it on there, then you can go ahead and move it, except for you have to confirm it once again, and then you can pull it over. So it kind of gives you these guidelines. Those are just kind of cool. Then you can just click off of it somewhere, and then you get another copy and pull it. And when you copy like that, it also copies what is called the styles. And so the outline came with it and all that. If you didn't do it that way and you just wanted to copy the layer, only like the words would come over, not the styles or the outline. You know, this is one way to do it. Like I said, there's several ways, but I find this easiest for beginners. Okay, so when you have your design the way that you want it, you can go ahead and then save it. And what I like to do is first we need to come over here to the background layer and go to merge visible, and that will put everything on one layer. And you go over to file and save as. And so I don't like to override, I guess it's called, the original file, because I like the original paper the way it was. So that's why you have to do save as, and then you have to rename it or add words to it to make it a different file. And you have to save it under PSD for Photoshop if you want to be able to make adjustments, like saying I want to change the B mine back to black or whatever in a future use. And so if that is the case, then I save it in PSD. And so I save it there. What I also do is go in and then change it to a JPEG or a PNG, but those you can't edit, those files. Only a PSD can you edit in Photoshop. Okay, so I've already done that, so I'm just gonna push cancel. And I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. Okay, so now we have the template. And the first thing I want to do is actually go up to view and put it to the size of the print size, actually. And I like to turn off the save area because I'm going to be working with the background and the bleed area for this next step. I'm going to bring in that paper by going to file and place, and then placing that paper that I want to use. So now that I have this in here, I'm going to hold down my shift key, and so that when I pull the edges, it goes proportionately and it doesn't get distorted. And so I'm going to try to put that exactly where I want it. And that looks good. So now that I have the paper pretty much where I want it, we're gonna have to get the digital paper and place it right over the background like that. And we're gonna clip the digital paper to the background by using clipping mask. And there's a couple of ways to do that, but the quickest way for the beginner is just to go right here, right to click, and then create clipping mask. And see, that goes ahead and makes the digital paper the shape of the background. And that way you pretty much have your bleed in there and your design. You can still actually move it and even make it bigger by holding down the shift and repositioning it. And so now you want to turn on the save area, and you see that is where the actual blank will go, and that includes the bleed area. But you can't print with it. You can just double check that it's in the right area and that everything looks good, and then you want to take it off before you print it. So those are the steps that you need to take in order to design a sublimation template, this one that is a chapstick holder, and by using clipping masks and your own digital paper. So hopefully that was helpful. Thank you.